我想問翻咧，其實係咪即係你都仍然覺得追擊其他民化民主派嗰個路線，其實呢個路線即係正確會繼續做嘅咧？同埋即係民主黨都講過話，即係黨委會同你哋劃清界線嘅呢啲。
其實林慧卿講呢句荒謬嘅，其實佢入咗中聯辦，喺舊年投票支持咗啲立憲嗰方案，已經劃清咗界線嘅啦。係嘛？即係加下次講劃清界線。喂，你當初步入呢個中聯辦嗰陣時候，你已經同泛民同我哋劃清界線啦，係嘛？佢行為本身已經劃清界線啦。咁所以加下次講劃清界線，我覺得真係係一個嘅，即、就、係、是、利用呢一個嘅氣氛情況之下，對我哋再進一步抹黑打壓嘅啫嘛。其實我哋一早已經退出咗呢個泛合會，我哋根本就冇參與嗰個泛合會嘅協調。你加下咁同我講劃清界線，係你投共支持咗呢個偽政改方案，同我哋劃清界線啊嘛，真係。
會唔會再有啲咩機會，即
係
可以同民主黨或者
係
泛民合作？有冇啲？
我哋唔會同一啲出賣選民嘅人有任何妥協。
我講補充一點啦，即係其實我哋頭先正如大家所講，我哋其實晨早就已經同佢劃清界線啦，唔係同路人啦。但係佢而家先嚟講，就係證明佢之前就不停想用好似扮同路人就話界票，到選完之後咧，佢先至話唔係同路人。咁我希望佢哋能夠一致咧。如果佢哋而家已經劃中我哋唔係同路人嘅話咧，我希望呢個所謂界票啊什麼分佢票呢個説法就唔好再出現啦。如果唔係咧，兩個係完全矛盾嘅。因為既然我哋唔係同路人啦，我哋同佢參選，同佢競爭，就絕對冇所謂界唔界票呢樣嘢，或者即係分咗佢嘅票呢個咁嘅説法。
Mr. Chan, you ran your campaign on a single issue, which is penalizing the Democrats, but the voters by and large elected Democrats and rejected dual power. So does that mean that your ideology is soundly rejected by voters?
We said that right at the beginning, you know, it is a new democratic movement. A movement require education, organization, and people's awakening. And it is impossible to ask the people change their minds overnight. So the campaign is a long one, and we will continue this campaign as long as we achieve the goal of universal suffrage for all. If you look at the world, the people power,obtain about 10% of the popular vote, to us, you know, which is quite a satisfactory level. But if you look at the overall number of people come up voting, the role of the DP receive is much higher than us. So if you look at the movement or the campaign itself, it is not a successful one. But we will continue this struggle and continue this campaign until the objective is met.
阿勇，我想問，尋日咧，因為梁家傑講話，如果公民黨咧，即係想集結埋泛民一齊坐低再傾嘅，如果佢揾埋你哋同埋民主派一齊再傾，可唔可行？有冇啲咩條件嘅先肯？
我哋就好被動，講句難聽啲係嘛，即係由第一日開始，你支持政改方案，譬如話再推遲啲，你反對五區公投嗰陣時，我哋都係花咗好多時間，譬如喺呢個2009年嘅九月份。我去同何俊仁傾過兩次，為咗呢個五區公投，我預約你三個坐低有傾過，跟住再以後亦都有幾次嘅商談，但係嗰陣時佢哋已經同共產黨進行呢個秘密談判，事後已經睇到曬啲事實問題，你已經賣咗我一次嘅啦五區公投，咁好啦，好明顯你反對唔緊要，跟住政改你又嚟多次，係咪呢個係事實嚟噶嘛，大哥係咪啊？咁你政改又嚟多次咯喎？咁我哋舊年6/25我哋喺門口已經正式宣布佢唔係民主派啦。跟住我哋先發起個票大票上運動啊嘛，大家睇下個過程先得㗎。我哋由頭至尾都係被動嘅，係咪？所以今時今日，譬如公民黨話號召即係泛民應該整合，係咪？喂，我哋真係好被動喎。佢琴日已經行出嚟，喂，放馬過嚟啦，你未驚過啦？咁你大佬啊，佢第一大黨係咪？咁你點同佢？即係呢個，你問佢唔係問我哋，啱唔啱？我哋邊個人都一樣。即係我以前等於我同即係陳方新出嚟參選嘅時候，我講一句説話：一些人不管他以前做過什麼、説過什麼，只要今天站到人民這一邊，我們都表示歡迎，係咪？即係我哋係被動嘅 ，OK？ 咁但係即係好多人會關心呢個泛民嘅整合問題，泛民嘅分裂係舊年。呢一個所謂政改之後已經係分裂嘅啦，呢個已經好清晰嘅啦嘛。你睇翻政改嗰個投票記錄，泛民主派23個議員嗰個投票嘅記錄，啱唔啱？即係你公民黨今次喺選舉裏邊受到嚴重嘅抹黑打壓，喂，民主黨都有份嘅民協，但係佢一個聯盟嘅參選， 民，所以我覺得很可惜，所有的合作都是要大家有一個共識， OK， 有一個共識，大原則相同，大家技術上面在其他的細節上面是可以即係調整，你要求同存異啊嘛，係嘛？咁但係而家事實上睇到目前係冇呢個基礎，係嘛？咁但係我哋係好被動嘅，我哋做我哋嘅嘢啦，係咪？
既然你話要，我想補充一點啫，我想補充一點，即係其中一個就係個誠信問題。如果大家記得咧，即係舊年，即係當我同阿鍾敏仍然係呢個社民聯嘅年代咧，我哋有封信俾咗何俊仁嘅 ，OK， 就翻呢一個嘅民主黨同共產黨密室政治啊，喺背棄呢個盟友情況之下，承諾咗支持呢個政改方案。我哋嗰一次就要求佢俾一個承諾，我哋嗰時仲未退出泛亞會，我哋要求佢俾個承諾，你會唔會日後再有呢一啲咁樣嘅密室政治同埋呢一個嘅協商嘅時候，你知會聲你嘅盟友？佢拒絕承諾，佢拒絕俾個承諾，我哋要退出泛亞會嘅，係嘛？唔係我同你一齊去爭取緊呢個民主。你竟然不願意俾個承諾我哋，你不會再賣我哋豬仔，你賣到我哋兩次豬仔啦嘛，你欺騙咗選民兩次啦嘛，我俾多次機會你，係嘛？你會唔會即係肯承諾以後再有任何類似嘅嘢，你會支援我哋？我唔係叫佢唔做喎，你支援我哋，佢都拒絕啊嘛。我嗰陣時用通奸嘅例子啫嘛。喂，你走去同人通奸，哦，跟住俾人發覺咗，跟住。就問你話你會唔會再唔通奸？喂，咁你拒絕承諾唔會再通奸嘅話，我咪同你離婚啫嘛，好簡單啫嘛。去到今日為止，你問翻你次問翻何俊仁，佢會唔會俾泛民一個公開嘅承諾，以後再有呢啲密室政治會支援盟友啊？
阿鍾啊，問翻，既然你話人民力量而家係即係一直都係被動狀態，咁其實係咪即係話仲有空間同泛民
派？我咧就即係其實即係好難答你呢個問題嘅，真係對唔住。第一。我是人民力量的執委成員之一，主席就坐在隔壁。OK， 我哋應該就喺呢個月，應該下個月頭，我哋會開一個集思會，我哋會檢討整個運動嘅成敗同埋嗰個未來嘅，即係嗰個走向，係嘛？同民主派嘅關係，咁呢啲都會喺我哋集思會裏邊咧達成一個結論嘅。我個人嘅意見就唔可以代表個會，係嘛？唔可以代表人民力量。咁而且跟住落嚟，我嘅角色都係集中喺嗰個培訓教育嗰度嘅，因為我哋已經即係購買咗個普羅政治學院嘅校址，啊，咁我哋明年年頭開始咧就即係準備要即係開班，係嘛？咁我哋會集中好多，即係我係大部分嘅時間都喺個普羅政治學院度嘅，我哋會做政策研究啦，啊，即係嗰個論述嘅培訓啊等等。咁就會喺出邊，即係喺個選舉之前，我哋都會先做一啲係，即係為咗出邊立法會選舉嗰個部分。咁所以我大部分時間喺嗰度嘅。咁而家我哋成個人民力量嘅領導層咧，主要就係以呢個劉家雄為首啊，呢班後生仔。咁我哋喺下個月頭會開會，即係傾呢啲問題。
可唔可以問翻主席咧？你覺得即係今次你追擊咧，令到即係建制派成為大贏家咧？你哋間接係咪都共有一個貢獻喺度？
你呢個講呢個問題嘅講法個邏輯
係，你呢個叫 loaded question 啦，就係即係你將一個已經。assume 咗一樣嘢，又問我電係咩咧？我想我嗰個所謂我哋嘅責任呢樣嘢，我睇唔到個責任喺邊度。既然尤其是劉慶已經講咗出嚟話，我哋並唔係佢嘅同路人，咁我出嚟競選點會影響到所謂追擊咧？點會影響佢嘅選情咧？而家佢呢個説法就係話，今次投咗我哋票嗰啲選民，如果我哋唔參選，啲票户係俾翻佢哋嘅。咁呢個係一個非常之可笑嘅説法嚟嘅，因為我哋今次成個票債票償運動，特別係即係針對或者同民主黨或者係民協競選嘅區分，我哋嘅最主要嘅立場就係要懲罰佢哋。如果選民投得俾我哋嘅票數，就係代表佢唔會支持佢哋啦。如果既然唔會支持佢哋嘅話，佢點能夠話我哋嘅參選啊係戒佢票咧？嗰啲票唔係佢嘅，嗰啲票係就算我哋唔參選。以我哋今次嘅成個咁嘅運動嘅立場嚟講，嗰啲就算我哋唔參選，嗰啲票都唔會俾到佢嘅。既然啲票唔會投翻俾佢嘅話，點會能夠佢哋嘅敗選係我哋嘅？
我覺得咧，即係呢個分票嘅講法係好荒謬嘅。即係我唔知你哋嗰個諗法係點啦。即係任何一個選舉民主政治個定期選舉嘅目的係咩？定期選舉嘅目的就係俾選民有個機會去換嗰啲不稱職嘅政客，係咪？唔係做啲辦選舉啫， 係咪？好簡單嘅嘛，呢個道理都唔明，呢個常政治常識嚟嘅啦。點解要有定期選舉啊？點解會有政黨輪替啊？咁啊，永遠都唔使啦。如果票係你，唔係一個夾硬鎖起佢，下次選舉攞翻出嚟。
第二個問題就係你頭先所講係泛民主派咧。我哋今次即係票價票上運動咧，要懲罰嘅係民主派係民主黨同埋民調，其他泛民主派嘅敗選嘅原因咧有各方各面。我唔覺得會同我哋人民有任何關
係。我想倒翻轉問，
係
你幫咗建制派
嘅。喂，呢個荒謬嘅，我再講多一次啦。其實呢個説法，或者佢哋如果繼續咁講嘅話咧，其實係即係都幾，我要幾嚴正咁樣講咧，佢係侮辱咗投票俾我哋嘅選民。佢意思就係話，如果投咗票俾我哋嘅選民，如果我哋唔參選就會俾佢哋。呢個係非常之可惡嘅説法，亦都係對於投票我哋俾我哋嘅選民嘅一種侮辱嚟。咁我希望佢哋唔好繼續咁，或者各位即係傳媒或者其實評論人咧都要好小心呢種説法。如果唔係嘅話，咁個個參選都係戒咗㗎啦。咁邊個戒邊個都冇人知㗎喎。其實係咪？
其實你從選舉政治嚟講咧，一有選舉政治就有選舉嘅恩怨情仇嘅，全世界都係知，係咪？即係輸嗰個又賴，贏嗰個又賴。即係阿基講一句説話好有趣嘅，佢話成也追擊，敗也追擊。佢成功咧就因為我哋追擊，佢失敗咧又係因為我哋追擊。咁你講曬佢啦，係咪？即係話俾一到選舉政治咧就係咁嘅。所以我頭先一開宗明義同大家講，我哋係承認咗呢個運動失敗。OK， 我哋從一個政治運動嘅角度，呢個係鼓動風潮造成時勢自覺惡態，同一個政治嘅醒覺運動失敗咗嘛。選民唔支持你，咁我哋會檢討個原因咯。可能香港嘅選民咧就比較保守啲啊，香港支持民主派嗰啲咧，到頭來個棄保效應又出咗嚟啦。我哋都會檢討嘅。咁於是我哋將來再做同樣嘅嘢嘅時候，譬如包括明年，我哋可能會推動一個類似運動嘅時候咧，我哋就會調整而家個策略同埋個論述嘅方式啦嘛。呢個俾我哋一個好好嘅教訓同埋經驗嘅。任何一次選舉嘅挫敗，都係下次成功嘅一個基礎嚟。
咁想
問
咧，就
係
寫文件去大
拜
就主席就落台啦。咁你哋承認你今次運動失敗，你自己會唔會負責落台？
我哋今次咧，即係呢個運動咧，本身咧，就如果從選舉嘅角度啊，從選舉嘅角度咧，我哋之前都講過咧，我哋希望可以保到我哋本身嘅議席，同埋咧得票率係10%嘅。咁如果得票率咧，整體我哋參選嘅區份咧，得票率平均得個10%咧，呢個我哋成功咗嘅。而我哋本身有兩個區議會議席咧，本身陳偉業嗰個議席咧，佢自己就冇再選人去同呢個何俊仁去競選啦，同埋呢個沈錦添啦。咁而另外一位區議員即係喺我側邊嘅物業成員，佢係成功當選嘅。咁所以咧，我哋純粹係以呢個參選嘅角度咧，咁我睇唔到我哋有任何失敗之處。咁但係如果同呢個運動嘅角度咧，因為我頭先都講咗啦，我哋今次係並唔成功，並未能夠說服泛民主派的選民咧，係支持我哋呢個運動，咁我哋會繼續做，但係我睇唔到有需要嘅。
就等同你問孫中山，即係搞呢個革命啫嘛，咁有10次起義失敗，咪一次起義失敗，孫中山就辭職嘅，
係嘛？咁我哋係一個集體負責制嘅，即係而家要辭就主席辭嘅，就係代表我哋。我即係階段性嘅嘛，我呢個係一個選舉總公投，咁而家總公投俾人炒魷魚，係咪？咁但係我哋係會好誠心去負責嘅，即係我哋覺得我哋係對我哋嗰啲支持者咧，即係我哋有負佢哋嘅期望，呢個我哋係要即係對佢哋表示即係一個歉意，呢個我哋係公開講嘅。對於我哋嘅支持者，即係我哋有負佢所託，同埋有負佢嘅期望，同埋我哋即係必須要喺度多謝62位即係參選嘅朋友，喺咁短嘅時間裏邊去參與呢一場運動，係嘛不計成敗，係咪？即係犧牲個人嘅時間，有啲又要請假，係咪？即係呢個我哋係即係非常之感激。